First bass of the 2022 season. Welcome to the video. My name is John. I'm gonna be fishing the team tournament tomorrow by myself. I don't have a teammate. That wasn't even a keeper, but 2022 season underway. It's 33 degrees. It's 9 in the morning. I tried throwing a Damiki rig out in some deeper water at first, and I had a few come up. I even had a couple of bites for the first hour and a half or so, but I didn't connect with any of them. So I decided to switch gears and look for some largemouth. Anyway, not a keeper, but in this video, follow along. I'm going to show you how I practice for this video, and hopefully I catch some fish, and we'll see how I do in the tournament tomorrow. There'd be a boat idling by right now. This one might actually keep. So I should mention, I don't think I mentioned in the first little bit, first fish, that fish came on a drop shot. Water temperature's that one's probably just a keeper. Probably just at 15. Anyway, first one was on a drop shot. Water temp when I got on the lake was 40 degrees. Air temperature is probably up to 40 plus degrees now. Water temp's up to 41 something. Of course, that boat would be idling by now. I haven't had a bite in an hour. And first bite, there's a boat idling by. Anyway, that one was on a swim bait. And I don't know, it's too largemouth. The wind's supposed to really blow tomorrow, 20-25 out of the south. If you're familiar with Kansas, you know that's gonna suck.
A few moments later.
Hey. Alright, it's only been three more casts since I last spoke to you. That one's obviously not a keeper. But I did find a bank where they are and a lure that they'll eat. I can confirm now though that it is 10:53, water temp's 42, 22. I need to run back to the truck and get my hat. I forgot my hat. Can't see anything. Forgot my coffee. That's just how we roll in the Wilder neighborhood. I just wanted to give a tip real quick since I'm throwing a drop shot, but I'm getting ready to put it away, is for the weight when you're traveling, what I do is I take one of my daughter's hair ties, like one of the real small ones, and I put it on the butt of the rod, and then so when I go to run down the lake, I don't know if you're like me, but with the drop shot it used to just always bounce around and cause trouble and get tangled in things. Anyway, now what I do is tuck it in here. Of course it's not going to go smoothly since I'm trying to do it on film, but anyway, so I tuck it in there, that way when it's riding down the lake it just sits like that. That's the most it does. It doesn't really bounce around more than that. So that was actually a pretty, you know, aggressive bite. The other two bites that I've had on the swim bait particularly, well, even the drop shot, the first one that I had, they just kind of loaded up. You know, I really couldn't set the hook. I kind of had to reel into them. It was just mushy. But that was a thump thump. All right, this cove seems to be loaded with them. There's a boat. So I just gotta get out of here. But that was two solid bites. I apparently also need to change my hook. By the way, I should make it clear, when I'm trying to hide things from these guys, it's not because I'm better than them and I have some unkept secret. I'm just saying that these guys probably don't need any help though. I mean, I've never been here before, so these guys are probably all over them and I'm just catching scraps, but I still don't want to advertise what I'm doing and what may be working. So all right, let's run to another spot. There's too many boats here. Swim bait bite is a thing, at least today. I mean, I was just around way back in the back trying to see if maybe they'd be on any wood at all, how far back they've been. But when I come out to the rocks and throw a swim bait, I don't know, that's like my fifth bite or something. So I mean, I just hope that it continues tomorrow. I think I've only had the one keeper bite. Well, I had one that had some weight to it that came off back over there. But I mean, otherwise, ones I'm catching are short. But that's, I'd at least do that. I was afraid that I was going to get skunked, not even catch a fish. So I'm glad to hear that they're hitting the swim bait. That's fantastic. I was snagged. That one just had to have been just looking at it. When I finally popped it free, I hooked him under the gill. So funny. I tell you what, I'm going to be a one rod Todd tomorrow. I mean, I did catch one on a drop shot, but if I can throw a swim bait all day and even catch 13 inches like that, that'll be fun with a chance at some keepers. I bet you it's going to be rough tomorrow. You know, there might be one or two big bites, but I think a team just probably needs four keepers. You know, if somebody gets three keepers and four keepers and a big bite, you're going to do well. That's just my summation of the lake. Again, I've never been here. Well, let me show you this. The one thing that I did do is, as I made a map, I finally map studied. I don't know which way it goes, or if you can even see it with the sun. But, you know, usually I just show up to these lakes and just go. I mean, I'll put a few hours in on Saturday, maybe. I mean, these last three or four tournaments, I would just go. I've never been to the lake before, and I wouldn't even really, you know, Google Earth it. I just would go. And then figure it out on Saturday and fish on Sunday and do okay. But I want to do better than okay. I wouldn't mind, you know, beating these guys, or at least try, at least making a show. So anyway, did some studying, fishing some of the spots that I thought looked good. They are panning out with some short ones. And my guess is if somebody comes in with 4 15-inch fish, they're going to do well tomorrow. I could be way wrong. We're going to find out in like 5 or 6 minutes, however long this video is. It was way better at first. Having a fun day. I just wish I remembered my hat. I'm gonna have to figure something out. I would have gone and gotten it by now, but there's a ramp, and I don't do well with hills. I'm old and I'm fat. It's not a good combination with hills. Things always mess up my carpet. They slime it so bad. It's 2 p.m. Got off the lake at 2. It's 2:15. I should be home by 4:15. That's 2-hour drive home, 2-hour drive back. I have some rigging to do. I eliminated a lot of water, and I was practicing, I definitely don't want the wind, but expecting there to be 20, 25 mile an hour winds tomorrow out of the south. So, you know, I showed you a little map that I drew. I kind of traced and then, you know, made some notes and that sort of thing. And I had multiple spots that I wanted to investigate today that I thought would do well, but practicing for the wind, I only probably found 2 spots, and I'll just have to milk them until the trolling motor dies, which it will die because I need new batteries. such is life. We'll report back when I have something more important to say. All right.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
Never fails. Got to be in bed in an hour. Hit the road at 4:30 in the morning. I'm going to find out the trailer light's busted. Please have one. That was amazingly harder than it needed to be for me. Oh my goodness. I have to say the best part about spending a couple of hours fixing the trailer lights is that I left the truck lights on the entire time, and now we have to jump the truck. So things are going well. Things are going well. Oh, geez, Louise. It's just going to be one of these types of tournaments. That can't be right. This clock must be broken. It says it's only 3:43 in the morning. Man, did it not go well last night, let me tell you.
So last night we tried jumping the truck, and when I got in the truck and closed the door, my hood closed, and it didn't close all the way. It closed enough to latch, but not enough that I could use the latch release to unlatch it. I can't even make this stuff up because I didn't know it was a thing. I didn't even know that could happen. The jumper cables were sitting on the battery, and to the point where it allowed the hood to close 90% of the way. So it latched, but we couldn't unlatch it. So I stopped filming at that point for two reasons. The main reason, I was only saying cuss words. The second reason is it's possible that I threw my phone somewhere in the dark and had trouble finding it.
Allegedly.
Anyway, we got to get going. As Scott Barton says, and I take it from him, I steal it from him, we got to go.
Get everything situated.
Well, you don't happen to have an SD card, do you? I left mine at home. I took it out of my phone, but it's not working. Yeah. I literally just had to cut off a jig so that I could open my phone to get the SD card out to put it in the GoPro just so I could film, because I took the SD card out last night, and then in my rage, I forgot to put it away. Oh my God, what a day. Haven't even started yet.
I do, yeah.
How you doing, sir?
Good.
I guess I should even have checked that I have $20. That would have been helpful. There you go, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Wilder.
Oh,
come on, baby. Turn it up. Turn it up. Woo!
The shoe is on the hand, it fits. There's really nothing much to quit. Whistle through your teeth and spit, cause it's all right.
It touches. Number one. I don't even know if the camera's getting this or not.
Swallowed it. Probably not a keeper though. ¼, of course. That's all right, two fish. Man, I hope this SD card is working. It's the SD card from my phone. I don't know if I mentioned. It keeps giving me an SD card error too, so I don't know if I'm getting any of this, but. All right, that's two fish. It's only 8 something, whatever. We're doing it.
5 hours later.
I put up a good fight with these sticks and rocks.
Results are in. It was tough, as I thought it would be. As I predicted, it, you know, 5 keeper fish is basically all that it took to win. There weren't any really, there's maybe one big fish short of 4 pounds caught. The rest of them were all just, you know, 15 to 16 inch fish. Judging by the weights, you know, I think 13 pounds won or something like that. So my prediction was right in that regard. My prediction for what I would throw and catch 13 or 14 pounds was obviously wrong. I only caught one keeper, not great, but you know, there was 8 teams or so that didn't even catch a fish, keeper fish. Who knows, maybe they caught shorts like I did too. But you know, it was tougher than I thought. I have a tournament coming up there in a couple of weeks. It's called Mr. Bass, to try and make the Kansas State team, I think. And I just got this too. So I didn't come home empty handed. I guess I can close this.
Look at this. Look at this little thing. 2021 East Kansas Bassmasters Big Bass of the Year. I didn't realize that I caught the biggest bass of the year last year. So, I mean, I know I had a one that was over six. I don't actually remember the weight, but I didn't realize it was the biggest of the year. So that's cool that I got that. So I didn't come home empty-handed, and I'm hoping that this is fortune-telling for the next couple of weeks. So stay tuned. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. The next tournament coming up, again, is going to be back at Melvern. So now I'm mad at the lake, and I'm gonna go back down, and I'm going to try and get a day or two of practice in before this upcoming tournament. And I'm going to take it as serious as I can. And I'm coming for him. Thanks for watching.